This is Dr. B, and let's do the Lewis structure for PO43-. Phosphate has 5 valence electrons. Oxygen has 6. We've got 4 oxygens. And this negative 3 up here means we have 3 additional electrons. 5 plus 24 plus 3 gives you 32. So those are our valence electrons. Put phosphate at the center and the oxygens around it. All 4 of them. We'll draw bonds between the oxygen and the phosphorus. So we're forming chemical bonds right here, 2 electrons each. So we've used 8. And then let's fill the octets for the oxygen. So we used 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, and 32. So we've used all 32 of the valence electrons. Each of the atoms has an octet, and it really feels like we're done with this one. But phosphorus is in period 3. It can hold more than 8 valence electrons. So let's check our formal charges to see if this is the best structure. For the phosphorus on the periodic table, it has 5 valence electrons. All of these right here are involved in bonds. So we have 0 non-bonding, but we have 2, 4, 6, 8 bonding. We'll divide that by 2. That gives us a +1 formal charge for phosphorus. For oxygen on the periodic table, 6 valence electrons. Each oxygen has 6 of these non-bonding valence electrons, and then 2 bonding, which we divide by 2. 6 minus 6 minus 1 gives us -1 as the formal charge on the oxygen, and they're all the same. So we know we have to end up with a 3- as the total formal charge, and that's not working right now. And I can see that on the phosphorus, there's this +1 right here. What I can do when I see a +1 like that, if I move 2 electrons from one of these atoms and form a double bond, that should resolve the +1. So let's see if that works. So what I've done is I've taken these 2 electrons that were out here and I've formed a double bond. Now when I check my formal charges, the phosphorus ends up being 0, which is much better. And this oxygen right here, 6 minus the 4 non-bonding, and then the 4 bonding divided by 2, that's 0. And the other oxygens remain at a -1, so we end up with a total charge of -1, -2, -3, which makes a whole bunch of sense. So this is the best structure for phosphate ion, Lewis structure for PO4-. We do need to put brackets around it, and a 3- out here so that everyone knows that it is indeed the phosphate ion. That's the Lewis structure for PO4 3-. Bit tougher. Watch your formal charges. You'll get the correct structure. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.